Welcome to my class on electronic displacements in organic molecules, covalent compounds, like inductive effect, mesomeric effect, electromeric effect, inductomeric effect, resonance effect. In all these things, in the present class, I would like to discuss about inductive effect only. This is also called as polarization effect. In this, a covalent bond between two dissimilar atoms will be taken as well, like carbon and other group or element X. Assuming X is the electronegative than carbon, then that carbon will get positive charge, partial positive charge, and X will get partial negative charge. The same thing will be noticed when another group which is less electronegative than carbon, assuming as Y, this Y will get partial positive charge and carbon will get partial negative charge. That means the electron pair forming sigma bond is not said to be shared equally between the two atoms, which is actually attracted towards more electronegative atom. This discussion is the discussion in these examples. So in these two examples, what we have noticed is nothing but this comes under the category of polarization effect. Okay, and this is nothing but inductive effect, which causes certain degree of polarity in the bond, which in turn renders the bond much more liable to the Welcome to my class on electronic displacements in organic molecules, covalent compounds, like inductive effect, mesomeric effect, electromeric effect, inductomeric effect, resonance effect. In all these things, in the present class, I would like to discuss about inductive effect only. This is also called as polarization effect. In this, a covalent bond between two dissimilar atoms will be taken as well, like carbon and other group or element X. Assuming X is the electronegative than carbon, then that carbon will get positive charge, partial positive charge, and X will get partial negative charge. The same thing will be noticed when another group which is less electronegative than carbon, assuming as Y, this Y will get partial positive charge and carbon will get partial negative charge. That means the electron pair forming sigma bond is not said to be shared equally between the two atoms, which is actually attracted towards more electronegative atom. This discussion is the discussion in these examples. So in these two examples, what we have noticed is nothing but this comes under the category of polarization effect. Okay, and this is nothing but inductive effect, which causes certain degree of polarity in the bond, which in turn renders the bond much more liable to the attacked by the charged atom or groups. With reference to inductive effect, it is very important to note that electron pair, although permanently displaces, it remains in the same valence shell, is the most crucial important point to be noticed. For example, in this example, we have electron pair movement is towards X is there. Here towards carbon is there. But the pair of electrons remains in the valence, same valence shell is the notice in the inductive effect. So inductive effect is giving about the information that electron pair is, but it is not leaving its valence shell, is most important point. That means it is not a complete transfer like ionic bond, but it may gives the ionic nature to the covalent bond. So what is inductive effect? Inductive effect may be defined as the permanent displacement of electrons. It is defined as permanent displacement of electrons forming a covalent bond. towards the more electronegative element or group. That is the definition for inductive effect. So here this is a kind of displacement of bond pair of electrons, sigma bond electrons, particularly sigma bond electrons. So inductive effect is always said to be transmitted along a chain of carbon atoms. Further, we have so many other examples are there. When you consider any of the carbon chain like this, a group is there, like X is there in this again, or you could want like halogen, chlorine also you can take. In this, the bond between this carbon and chlorine, this carbon I am taking C1, this is C2, this is C3. And this bond, covalent bond, movement will be there towards chlorine. Because of this inductive effect idea, this chlorine will get partial negative charge, this C1 carbon will get partial positive charge. This will be transmitted in a carbon chain up to the second carbon of the carbon attached group. So second carbon of the carbon attached group means C3, up to this one, this impact will be there. And that means this will be continued and C1 will try to take the electron density from C2. Then this arrow mark will be shown like this. That the presentation of the arrow mark pointing towards the more electronegative is called as inductive effect representation. In this C2 will get partial positive charge. More is the delta we are writing, lesser is the charge compared to the other one. So C2 is having lesser positive charge, partial positive charge than C1, indicated by two delta symbols. Likewise, if you write three delta symbols over C3, it indicates that C3 is having lesser partial positive charge compared to C2. So it will be negligible after this one. Suppose you have C4 is there, that impact is negligible. Negligible impact over the C4 of the source element. Source is chlorine. Okay. So this we will usually call it as inductive effect. Particularly we will call this inductive effect as negative inductive effect. That means the inductive effect, when it is transmitted along a carbon chain, in this up to C3 it was observed. That means one chlorine atom is greater electron affinity than the carbon, which is try to take the electron density from C1. Likewise, it continues up to C2 from C1, and C2 also tries to receive some density from C3. That means this pair of electrons, sigma bond electrons, are try to move towards electronegative groups. In such a case, we can understand one thing, that the inductive effect is represented by symbol arrow mark, and the arrow pointing towards more electronegative element or a group. In this case, we have shown, this is a simple example. Directly, we take an organic molecule like N-butyl chloride Also, it can be understand by taking the four carbon in the carbon chain. We have CH3, CH2, CH2, CH2. Like this last we have Cl is there. And this one point towards fluorine. This negative, this is positive, this is less positive, this is more less positive, this is fourth one, almost negligible, four deltas we are writing. And this arrow marks we are showing like this, inductive effect arrow marks. The decrease in the effect is denoted using greater number of signs, positive deltas, so it is almost negligible. This is almost negligible. So up to third carbon it will be there. So the electron attraction and repulsion is compared with hydrogen as a reference atom in a molecule. And this we have R3CH, if you take, is as a standard one here in this. This is a standard one. With reference to hydrogen, we will discuss the concept. Okay? So, any atom or group which attracts the electrons more strongly than hydrogen, which is said to exhibit an inductive effect, and that inductive effect is called as a negative inductive effect. So, now, in this case, what happened? Electron withdrawing tendency of chlorine noticed, and which is also greater electronegative than hydrogen, that inductive effect is classified as minus I effect. Okay. So here in this, the group should be electron withdrawing group. Okay. Electron withdrawing group or electron attracting group. Like we have a NO2 group is there. Cl is there. Br, Cl, I, F, etc. Carboxylic acid, etc. etc. They may come under this type of inductive effect. While some other atoms are there that attracts electrons less strongly than hydrogen, they will exhibit a positive inductive effect plus I effect. That means inductive effect is said to be classified in other way when we have a group which is electron repelling group is there. Okay. Or less attractive than hydrogen. In that case, that electronic effect is called as positive inductive effect, that is called as plus I effect. We have CH3 group is the best example for that one. Like that, we have C2H5 is there. And ME2CH is there. That means isopropyl is there. Tertiary butyl is also present in that case, etc. Examples. That means what is inductive effect? Inductive effect is playing an important role which will cause some polarization in the carbon chain. Okay. So that can be here shown by any of the example. Like if you take any one of these one, then you can easily understand a group is there, CH3. CH2 is there, and at last we have a one pair of one group is there. That group is CH3 group, suppose it is there, means any one of this group is there. I am taking Y like this. So what is happening is it tries to increase the electron density in the carbon chain. It will get positive charge, carbon chain will get negative charge like this. That is the example. So we can easily understand what is inductive effect from this discussion. So what is inductive effect? Inductive effect is nothing but there is a displacement of sigma bonded electrons in a carbon chain because of a group attached to the carbon chain towards or away from the carbon chain is called as inductive effect. Okay, so now we will see some important groups which cause inductive effect, positive inductive effect and negative inductive effect. Okay, now you can observe minus I effect groups. These are minus I effect groups. EWG stands for, what is EWG stands for? Electron withdrawing, electron withdrawing groups. You can also call their electron donating groups. Electron attracting groups. Electron attracting groups. Okay. What is ERG stands for here is, ERG stands for electron releasing groups. Electron releasing groups. Also we can call their electron repelling groups. Electron repelling groups. So in this NME3 nitrogen positive, NH3 positive, NO2, CN, COOH, F, CL, BR, I, OAR, COOR, OR, OH, CH6H5, CH double bond CH, H. And in the case of positive inductive effect showing groups are CH5O-, COO-, R3C, CHR2, CH2R, CH3H. And this is the actual order of the electron releasing groups and electron withdrawing groups which shows the inductive effect, you can observe. Next we will go to the applications of inductive effect. As I said earlier, inductive effect is most important phenomena in organic chemistry as it explains several effects, facts. The most of that facts are comes under the dipole moment categories, bond length category informations, as the strength of the carboxylic acids, reactivity of alkyl halides, as well as the ester formations and other important things. Now, in that first we will discuss about the effect on bond lengths. The first application is effect on bond length. Effect on bond length. As you know, inductive effect leading to the ionic character in the bond, it increases minus I effect usually decreases the bond length. That means minus I effect, whatever is there, if it is increasing the bond length or bond distance decreases. That is the important point to be noticed here. So we have alkyl halides examples. Information we will take alkyl halides like methyl halides, and their bond length also I will consider. Bond length also I will consider. In that methyl iodide I am taking. So you want CH3 like this, I can write. Methyl iodide, methyl bromide, methyl chloride, methyl fluoride. In all these, because of the polarization, the bond pair of electrons between carbon halogen tries to displace towards the halogen. the time the distance between carbon and iodine in the methyl iodide is noticed as 2.14 angstrom units, while that of bromide are noticed as 1.94 angstrom units, chloride noticed as 1.78 angstrom units, and that of fluoride noticed as 1.38 angstrom units only. 1.38 angstrom units only. What is the meaning of this one is nothing but bond length between carbon halogen and alkyl halides is decreasing. In this order, it is decreasing with the increase in the inductive effect of the halogen atom. Here, fluorine is more electronegative. It causes more inductive effect. Greater the inductive effect, lesser is the bond length, that was proved in this data information which is obtained for us. Okay. So, this is one important application of inductive effect. Because of inductive effect, bond length is changing. That is the first application. Let us move on to the next important application, that is called as dipole moment. Dipole moment. Usually we will mention this one in device. And that dipole moment also get affected because of inductive effect. But in this case, what they have noticed is nothing but dipole moment value. Dipole moment value increases when negative inductive value also increases. So, inductive effect increases, dipole moment value increases. So, which was noticed for different kinds of alkyl halides, in that methyl iodide noticed as 1.64 device, where that of methyl bromide noticed as 1.79 device, methyl chloride we got information that is 1.83 device, means increase in the dipole moment, increase in the inductive effect, dipole moment is increasing. Increasing. Inductive effect also increasing. Both are increasing. But it is inversely proportional. Here in the above case, bond length and negative inductive effect are inversely proportional. But in the case of dipole moment, that inductive effect and dipole moment value both are directly proportional. This was the second important thing we have noticed. That means, inductive effect leads to dipolar character in the molecule. It develops some dipole moment in a molecule. In that, dipole moment increases with increase in the inductive effect which was studied. Next. This is the third one, that is reactivity of alkyl halides. Reactivity of alkyl halides can also be understood from this one. That is, alkyl halides, usually they are said to be reactive, then they are corresponding alkanes. The reason is nothing but the presence of this halogen in the bond. That means between carbon and halogen, the bond in the alkyl halides makes alkyl halides more reactive than the corresponding parent alkanes. Because the bond towards the halogen is moving and making this is polar nature. Because of the polarity only, the alkyl halides are said to be more reactive than the corresponding alkanes. Because in alkanes, that kind of polarity is not observed. Because carbon hydrogen almost having negligible electronegativity difference is there. So, this is one reason. And moreover, if you directly consider methyl chloride as an example like this, you can understand this is the charge development. Due to this development of charges, on the one of the two atoms here which is attached to a covalent bond, the reagent can be easily facilitated over the alkyl halide rather than methane. So, If you take methane, this is the thing. So, when compared to this one, any kind of reagent to be attacked, which is easy? It is easy when this kind of polarity is developed. Okay. And in this, we have one more thing is there. So, you want to increase the reactivity of this kind of methyl halides, then we can use the alkyl groups in place of hydrogens of methyl group to increase their reactivity. See how? You can write tertiary compound, butyl compound like this, carbon. And easily you can say this kind of alkyl groups can be easily attacked by the reagents. That means the chlorine atom here in the tertiary butyl chloride can be very easily replaced by other atoms. So this can be easily replaced because of the positive inductive effect caused by these methyl groups in this tertiary butyl chloride. So this is one of the most important applications of this inductive effect. Inductive effect is causing the reactivity of alkyl halides is one important application. Okay. Okay. Strength of carboxylic acids. An acid is a species that has a tendency to lose protons, as you all know. What is acid is? Acid is a tendency to lose protons, and further, the strength of the acid actually depends upon the ease which the acid ionizes to give proton. So, two things are there. Strength of the acid is depending upon the ionization. And acid is a tendency of giving proton. These two things are important points. And the ionization of proton of carboxylic acids can be explained on the basis of the facts that is called as resonance stabilization concepts also. For example, if you take a carboxylic acid like RCOOH is a carboxylic acid. In this carboxylic acid general formula, we have electron pairs are there, you know, electron pairs are there over the oxygen, and this delocalization takes place. That time you can also write one more resonance structure like this. That is, here this is negative, like this. This will be double bond. This oxygen will get positive charge. This hydrogen. And here what we have noticed is in this structure, oxygen is, even though it is electronegative, it is getting positive charge. In that case, what will happen? Automatically, the structure, second one here, this structure, resuming is second one, this is the first one. In this structure, possibility of leaving the hydrogen from this oxygen is more for the carboxylic acid. That means undissociated carboxylic acid may become dissociated to give proton. Okay. So, the oxygen atom of carboxylic group has a positive charge here in this to which it is has a tendency to lose this hydrogen by attracting the electrons from it. Okay. So, how that can be represented is RCOOH slowly gives a proton, it becomes RCOO minus plus the proton. So what is this one? It is a carboxylic acid. Carboxylic acid which is undissociated. Which is undissociated. And what is this one? It is carboxylate ion anion. Carboxylate ion anion which is a dissociated one. Dissociated one. And in this, the carboxylate anion is said to be, which is formed actually more stable than the undissociated carboxylic acid. That is the point to be noticed here. That is, why it is stable is, it is stable because of, again, the information called as resonance stabilization. So, it undergoes resonance stabilization. It gives this one like this. And further, you can write the resonance hybrid which is more stable like this. That means electron cloud can be written like this. This is equally distributed. This is resonance hybrid. That means the existence of a carboxylate ion as a resonance hybrid is confirmed by its physical evidences also there, like the X-ray diffraction, electron diffraction studies. Thus, these acids undergo ionization easily in order to acquire more stable form, that is called as carboxylate ion. So, which is stable here? Carboxylate ions are more stable, because that's why these carboxylic acids are showing acidic nature easily, because of this inductive effect cases. The ability of this carboxylic acid is to give proton, that is fulfilled by the concept of inductive effect. So the acidity of carboxylic group may be also due to inductive effect and resonance stabilizations of carboxylic groups, carboxylic anions. We have there are some structural units are there, strongly electronegative groups which are there. If they are held with this alkyl group, then we can easily further increase the acidity of the carboxylic acids in its alkyl group. Okay, so that means, suppose if this is a CH3 group, like acetic acid if you take, here you can take acetic acid, formic acid, acetic acid examples. In this, you have any group is there, like X is there. If this X is electronegative, more electronegative, then what happens? This acetic acid strength gets more increased. And more is the X number over this carbon, that means alpha carbon. Automatically, what happens? This strength of the carboxylic acid increases, even that is strength is stronger than HCl also. Here, XX three times I wrote, indicates that the strength of carboxylic acid can be enhanced by using this kind of replacing this hydrogens, alpha hydrogens from this carboxylic acids. That we will see in a tabular form with its ionization constant also now. Let us see one important information related to the strength of the carboxylic acids which are associated with some electron releasing and electron withdrawing groups at the alpha carbon, particularly acetic acid and formic acid related dissociation constants of these compounds also, which are given in this table form. First one, we have propionic acid is there. In this, we have CH3 is present over this alpha carbon. It is 1.34 is there. CH3 causes positive inductive effect. So, acidic strength is less here. Dissociation constant is small value. Acetic acid, if you take, hydrogen is there. Hydrogen is not said to be encouraging more positive inductive effect compared to CH3. So, its value little bit increased. Formic acid, if you take directly, then this formic acid is said to be more acidic than acetic acid. 17.7 value is there, into 10 to the power minus 5. Methoxy acetic acid, if you take, 33.1 is there. The reason is nothing but these methoxy groups are electron releasing groups. Iodoacetic acid, bromoacetic acid. So, electron withdrawing tendency is increasing for the groups. Electron withdrawing tendency, oxygen is present. So, that's why it is 33.1. Iodoacetic acid 75, bromoacetic acid 138 in 10 power minus 5, chloroacetic acid 155 is there, fluoroacetic acid 217, cyanoacetic acid and aminoacetic acid we have 365 are there. What is the meaning of this one is, ended to effect increasing. Acidic strength increases. Particularly negative inductive effect cases we are discussing. That means inductive effect can also be further divided, discussed by keeping this halogen, particularly halogens on the alpha carbon. For example, if you take chlorine here, dichloro compound, dichloroestric acid if you take, particularly estric acid I am telling, dichloroestric acid like this. Anyways, this chlorine causes a negative inductive effect. Because of that one, what will happen is the entire bonds, all movement will be there towards this this side, carbon chain. So this is stronger than estric acid. Trichloroestric acid, if you see, in this we have three chlorine atoms are there. This will be more stronger than even hydrochloric acid because of this extent of negative inductive effect distribution in the carbon chain. Okay, so this is what we can understand. Progressively, the strength of the acid is increasing when compared to monochloro derivatives. So dichloro and trichloro derivatives are said to be more stronger than monochloroestric acids. Actually, what happened? The cumulative inductive effect of the three chlorine atoms which are absorbed in the trichloroestric acid, making it stronger than even the hydrochloric acid also. Next, moving on to the other things, if you observe, however, inductive effect decreases. When it decreases in this case of carboxylic acids, where the source atom or group and this inductive effect causing groups distance is increasing in the carbon chain, definitely the strength also changes. That means inductive effect decreases rapidly as the group responsible for the effect moves farther from the source. Then what will happen? The chloro acids, what we have discussed, that completely different from that of normal acetic acid. That means their strength is increased and then acetic acid strength. Likewise, we have further more examples are the like butyric acid. If you take butyric acid, chlorobutyric acids, in the chlorobutyric acids also the discussion happened in the same way. That is, that I will show you. I am going to take the chlorobutyric acids. I will write here by erasing this table. Dissociation constants of chlorobutyric acids and N-butyric acid, we are observing this order. This is alpha butyric acid. This is beta butyric acid. This is gamma butyric acid. This is N-butyric acid. And this Ka value in terms of 10 power minus 5 values you have taken, 139 is there. Source atom is source carboxylic acid. To release proton, this chlorine, negative inductive effect causes chlorine is present closer to the carboxylic acid. This is the source releasing its place close to this one. Beta is little farther from carboxylic acid group. And gamma is more farther, so that's why the value is decreasing. And in this case, you don't have any kind of negative inductive effect caused group over any of the alpha, beta, gamma carbons. That means the decrease the dissociation constant with increase the chain length between chlorine and carboxylic acid groups in acidic in the acidic nature of the types of this carboxylic acid, particularly butyric acid, is very clear from the evidence that inductive effect decreases when the distance from this source atom on the functional group increases. That is one thing. Another one we have, if you observe, as the hydrogen is said to be less electron repelling than other groups like methyl group and other propionic group and all, we have another list is there. That list, if you see, you can understand that what is the reason behind the different strengths of the carboxylic acid. So I will write formic acid here, HCOOH. I'll write acetic acid here. Like that, I'll write propionic acid here. I'll write tertiary isobutyric acid here. I'll write isobutyric acid. I'll write tertiary butyl acetic acid. So what happens in this case of formic acid, in terms of this Ka value into 10 power minus 5 values, if you observe, it's only 17.12 is there. Acetic acid, which was given as 1.75 only. Propionic acid, which is given as 1.33. While that of isobutyric acid given as 1.38, little irregularity noticed. But here, it is only 0.89, because these are causing positive indirect effect and electron repelling groups more are there over this carbon. Here 2 are there. Here 1 is there. Okay. In the case of acetic acid, directly attached to this one, here all hydrogens are there. No methyl group. Here hydrogen is present in the formic acid case. So that means formic acid in this hydrogen is said to be methyl group is there in the acetic acid, and formic acid we have hydrogen is there. So hydrogen is less electron repelling than methyl group. That's why formic acid is stronger than acetic acid. So which is stronger? Ka value is bigger for formic acid, is a stronger acid than acetic acid. And further we observed that propionic acid, we observed butyric acid, isobutyric acid, observed the butyric acid and trimethyl acetic acid. They are said to be further weak acids, and there is a slightly irregularity is noticed in the isobutyric acid, indicates that other factors affects the strength of the acid in the case of isobutyric acid. So these are the important points we have observed in the strength of the carboxylic acid, particularly monocarboxylic acids. That means only one COOH group in the carboxylic acids which is present. Hope you have observed the different factors what I have given it to you, that are the important applications of this inductive. The first I have discussed about the bond length, which is affected because of inductive effect, as well as the reactivity. I have noticed, I have given the information about the reactivity of the alkyl halides, dipole moment, strength of the carboxylic acids. Okay. Next we will see the bases also. Now let us discuss about another important factor, that is basic character of amines. Actually the basic character of amines is because of the proton acceptor behavior. That means they will donate the electron, unshared electron pair on the nitrogen atom and accepting the proton. This is the basic nature of amines. That means the readiness with which the lone pair of electrons is available to for the coordination with a proton, which determines the relative strength of the amines, relative basic strength of the amines. That means we have nitrogen is there in the ammonia case. Derivatives of ammonia are nothing but amines. So, in this, if you write the methyl groups, suppose if you write the methyl groups over the nitrogen, the ease of donating a pair of electrons over the nitrogen to the other proton and accepting the proton will increases. The tendency increases because this has got a tendency of releasing electrons, methyl group. If you have two are there like this, two methyl groups are there, so the tendency increases. We have three are there, that also increases, but only a discussion that is called as steric effect may changes the strength. In all these cases, methyl groups only electron repelling and they will increase the electron density over the nitrogen. Easily from the nitrogen, this amines can donate the electrons and accepts the protons via coordination. So this is due to the positive inductive effect of these groups, methyl groups. Even alkyl groups, you can say they are methyl groups, alkyl groups over the nitrogen atom becomes rich in electrons. With the result, what will happen? Lone pair of electrons on the nitrogen atom in amines is more easily available than in ammonia. Thus, ethyl amine, if you take ethyl amine, which is basic, that is nothing but CH3 CH2 NH2. NH, the notice that KB value for this one is 4.3 into 10 to the power of minus 4. 4.3 into 10 to the power of minus 4 is stronger than ammonia. Which is stronger than ammonia. You know, ammonia, we have only hydrogen is there. And this KB value for the ammonia is only 1.75 into 10 to the power of minus 5. So, what is the meaning of this one is nothing but this is all happening because of the positive inductive effect caused by this alkyl group, nitrogen. And further, trifluoromethylamine. If you take trifluoromethylamine, what happens? The electron density between this carbon and fluorine atoms move towards fluorine, and this pair of electrons cannot be easily donated by nitrogen. That means they have noticed there is no basic property at all in this case. No basic property at all due to negative inductive effect of fluorine atoms. Here fluorine atoms causing negative inductive effect. Here methyl groups causing positive inductive effect. That means positive inductive effect increases. Positive I effect increases. Basic strength increases. Negative inductive effect increases. Basic strength decreases. That is the meaning of this one. Okay. So, the combined negative inductive effect of three CF3 groups makes it poor and poor in this case. So, three fluorine atoms are making this is poor basic nature almost negligible. However, it is important to note that the relative basic strengths of the amines is not total in accordance with the inductive effect. That is completely different, that is based on steric effect also. In that, usually what we have observed, tertiary is greater than secondary, is greater than primary. But the order noticed, what is the order noticed, is nothing but secondary is greater than primary is greater than tertiary. That means secondary amines are more basic than primary amines. Primary amines are more basic than tertiary amines. The reason is the steric factor. Here, steric factor is also playing an important role. That means, inductive effect also governs basicity of substituted amines or enolines. The parent compound enolene is a weak base in the aliphatic amines because former case, what happens? Lone pair of electrons or nitrogen delocalize due to the resonance in the aniline cases. So, these are aliphatic amines. If you take aromatic amines, then delocalization also takes place. That will be little different than this one. So, in a case of the basic character, first we'll have the order. That order is observed like this. Okay. So, what is the order? This is the order. Secondary, greater than primary, tertiary in the aliphatic basic amines. Now, we will see relative strength of bases. Basic strength of amines, particularly amines. If the alkyl group is methyl group, then secondary amine is stronger than primary, then tertiary, then ammonia. If the alkyl group is ethyl group, secondary is stronger than tertiary, tertiary is stronger than primary, then ammonia. But the case is different. If the amines in the gaseous phase, then this is the order. Tertiary greater than secondary greater than primary and ammonia. In aqueous phase, secondary greater than tertiary greater than primary greater than NH3. That means in gaseous phase, tertiary amines are more basic than secondary amines, and which are more basic than primary amines. In aqueous medium, basicity of ethyl amines observed here in the secondary is stronger than tertiary. Tertiary is stronger than primary, then this is ammonia. This is in a gaseous phase. So, you have to understand one thing, that inductive effect is playing an important role in all these cases. Okay. I hope you understand this session. In the next session, I will continue this inductive effect applications along with the next important additional examples and all. And I will initiate the electromeric effect also in the next session. Until, have a nice day.